Hi friends, today let's see about how Brexit could create a crisis at the Irish border. The hardest part about Brexit is the borders. As a part of the European Union, the UK's borders have been relatively open for years. Trades carried out freely with other member countries and people coming through only need to show their European Union passport. But in June 2016, the UK voted to leave the European Union, so that it could reassert control on its own borders and decide who and what it wanted to let through. Imagine these boundaries of UK turning into hot borders. The impact of that on these maritime borders is complicated in terms of trade, but it could have serious implications for the people living along the UK. UK's only overland border is Northern Ireland. The border between Northern Ireland and the Republic of Ireland is one of the reasons why Brexit negotiations continue to reach a deadlock. That's because this is not just a boundary between two countries. It's also a compromise, a symbol of identity, a solution to a troubled history, and it's been keeping the peace in Northern Ireland for 20 years. Hardening the border could put one of Europe's greatest success stories in harm. The border between Northern Ireland and Republic of Ireland was first drawn in 1920 by the British, who had ruled over the island for centuries. The Irish had rebelled several times, but not everyone wanted the British to leave. So, eventually, the UK divided the island into two states based on its populations. Most people in Republic of Ireland were historically Catholic and identified as Irish and wanted independence. They were known as nationalists. But in Northern Ireland, many people are Protestant, identified more closely as British, and wanted to stay in the UK. They were called Unionist. After the partition, this part, Northern Ireland, remained in the UK as Northern Ireland. The South continued to move away from the UK until it gained complete independence and became a new country, the Republic of Ireland. At first, the 499 kilometers border of Northern Ireland was pretty porous, but the UK and Ireland continued to be hostile. Over time, custom checks were set up at the border crossings and the two countries descended into a trade war. Tariffs were placed on agriculture produce and goods like steel and coal. By the late 1960s, things turned violent. In Northern Ireland, fierce conflict broke out between extremist groups. Nationalist paramilitaries like Irish Republican Army believed that Northern Ireland was rightfully part of Ireland and that the British were oppressor of Northern Ireland's nationalist population. Unionist paramilitaries fought back, defending their places in the UK. Both groups blew up buildings, set off car bombs, and engaged in street fighting. The UK deployed thousands of troops to Northern Ireland during this time and became a common target of nationalist paramilitary attacks, especially at the border, which is for nationalists was the ultimate symbol of British occupation. As violence surged, the UK military tried to secure the border with walls, towers, heavy guns and patrols. They tightly controlled the 20 official crossings and screened people and vehicle passing through. The conflict over Northern Ireland turned this into a hot border. The violence lasted for more than 30 years, killed over 3,600 people and came to be known as the Troubles. It came to end in 1998 when nationalist and unionist parties leaders came together for a historic peace deal. They reached a compromise. Northern Ireland would remain in the UK, but people would be eligible for both Irish and UK citizenship. And in the future, Northern Ireland could vote to join Ireland. This deal came to be known as the Good Friday Agreement. It allowed nationalists in Northern Ireland to be part of Republic of Ireland, while the Unionists remained part of the UK, which meant this hot border was not needed anymore. So the British military left, the watchtowers came down and more roads opened. There are now around 270 official crossings, most of which are completely invisible, and they are all part of the border that stands as a symbol of compromise that ended decades of conflict. In June 2016, UK voted to leave the European Union, even though Northern Ireland was overwhelmingly in favor of remaining. 56% of remain and 44% of leave. The UK's argument in favor of Brexit was to control its own national borders, but there was little mention of its Irish border at the time. That changed when the UK and European Union started negotiations of status of the Irish border and become one of the first three things that figure out. The Brexit negotiations issues for the first phases, citizens' rights, financial state settlement, Good Friday Agreement regarding Northern Ireland. Now, more than a year later, it's still unresolved, but there are a few options. The first option is the UK could reimpose a hard border by bringing back the police and the walls, but that would isolate the population of nationalists in the Northern Ireland. Alternatively, it leave Northern Ireland in the European Union Custom Union. Here, Custom Union means free trade area, which has common external tariff. Okay, draw border in Irish Sea means separating it from the UK mainland, but this would betray the Unionist. See, either way, both these options risk violating the Good Friday Agreement. A third option is the UK stays in the European Union Custom Union, meaning it would not need customs borders, but that's unacceptable for Brexiters in the UK government, who specifically want control over their own borders. The UK needs put border somewhere, but just can't decide where. Now, there is a fourth option that would be in line with the Good Friday Agreement. It's the idea of reunification. In the past, when the both Ireland and the UK were in the European Union and the borders were open, there was little incentive for Northern Ireland to vote to reunite with the Republic of Ireland. But if the UK went with option of hard borders, Northern Ireland would be isolated and the only way to rejoin the European Union would be through reunification. Typically, this would be an overwhelming victory for the nationalist and a loss for the unionist. But Brexit seems to have changed some opinions. A recent poll found that 28% of the respondents who supported Northern Ireland place in the UK would now vote to join the Republic of Ireland. While not a perfect solution, it would give a Northern Ireland a voice about its own place in Europe, a voice that's barely been heard so far. Thank you, friends.